he's weighing the options. He's like, can I lie and get away with this? Well, I lied in a mayor. The story of Mayor Rob Ford of Toronto has become more and more enjoyable as time goes by. The guy is legitimately an 18-year-old high school kid in a mayor's body. Or a beluga whale's body. I don't mean a mayor, but I had to say it. So first, listen to this clown when he was in front of the legislature. This is unedited. This is unedited. Keep that in mind. Listen to how he responds to this direct question. Have you purchased illegal drugs in the last 2 years?
That was in 2013. Simpler time.
What's your order, Sergeant? Tossing a grenade!
Our side have struck first.
Shot, trooper! Where's the medic? Grenade out, watch it! Grenade out, look alive! Lobbing grenade! Back up!
Halfway there, keep it up.
Machine gun! One of theirs!
Take
Advance!
Oh, there comes another one.
We have almost won.
Shock trooper!
Reporters from the Toronto Star newspaper claim to have seen video of Conservative Toronto Mayor Rob Ford smoking a drug that appears to be crack cocaine. According to the Star, the video appears to show Ford in a room sitting in a chair, wearing a white shirt with the top buttons open, inhaling from what appears to be a glass crack pipe. Quote, I'm fucking right wing, Ford appears to mutter at one point. Quote, everyone expects me to be right wing. I'm just supposed to be this great. And his voice trails off. At another point, he's heard calling someone a fag. Later in the 90-second video, he is also asked about the football team. And he appears to say, though he is mumbling, they're just fucking minorities. This guy. If you wanted to write a how-to manual on how to destroy a political career, this guy's it right here. So, do we know all these things for sure? Honestly, I'd go as far as to say no. I've read 3 or 4 different articles about this. Multiple different places are reporting on it. But they all seem to... It's shaky because none of them are saying, like, definitively. And I haven't seen the video yet. I haven't seen the video online. But reporters have supposedly seen the video. I'm not 100% sold on it. I'm leaning towards it's probably true, or at least parts of it are true. But I'm going to shock the world. Are you ready? I don't care. No, and when I say I don't care, I mean, like, for example, if there was a video of Bernie Sanders that came out where he was smoking crack, I'd still vote for him. Now, I know, look, I know a lot of you might think that's outrageous. How could you possibly say that? That's absurd, right? Let me explain to you why that is. I wouldn't vote for this guy anyway, number one, because he said he's super racist. Calling people fucking...
That one?
They're just fucking minorities. calling someone fag. Well, for all these other reasons, and he's also a right-winger, which I usually am inclined to not agree with anyway, right? But I remember one of my best friend's parents, who is a world-renowned lung doctor. I mean, this is a guy who gives speeches all over the world, and he's done a tremendous amount of research. He's well-respected in his field, right? He told us a story about how he was giving a speech. I forget where that was, in Germany or France or Denmark or somewhere, right? And after he gave his lecture, people... some of the other doctors, some career doctors, approached him and asked him if he wanted to come to dinner and hang out and everything with them afterwards. So he went to dinner with them, and then they said, invited him back to one of their houses. They were all going to go and do heroin.
Oh my God.
Now, he's Americanized, so he was like, what the fuck? What? What? Like, it's the most outrageous thing to him, right? But to them, it's just, that's... the society they lived in, the culture they lived in, they have great careers, they make a good amount of money, they drive nice cars, they're all married, and they seem completely well-adjusted, but instead of on the weekend knocking back a couple Jack Daniels, it's just their drug of choice to do heroin. On Germany, they don't do it, they go about doing their job, whatever, it's just how they get their kids. Now, when you hear that story, you really have it click, and you go, oh, that's right. Whatever substance you take is just simply a matter of your culture and your preference. There's no moral lens to it. Just like Native Americans took peyote, just like other areas of the world are prone to other drugs. Here in the U.S., we like to pop pills and drink alcohol and smoke weed.
No, we smoke weed, but we don't fucking do
heroin. Now, is crack, am I saying that crack is equal to other drugs like marijuana and is the same? No, I'm not saying that at all. Obviously, some drugs are harder than others. But even with that being said, who cares, right? As long as it's not a problem, and you would be able to tell if it's a problem. You can tell an addict versus somebody who's not an addict. There's outward signs, there's evidence you can tell, right?
I don't know about that.
So,
it
doesn't bother me that much. I know I'm crazy.
I'll pass and stomp like
that. The only time it would bother me, other than the fact that I disagree with him politically again, but that aside, if he ran on a platform of being anti-drug,
is in the lead.
If he said, I'm going to clean up the streets and blah, 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 blah. It's like with all the Republicans, like, I'm a family values Republican. Next thing you know, they're banging a gay hooker with crystal meth.
Oh my God.
Right? So, the hypocrisy is what turns me off of what I would say. I don't trust you, and from a logical perspective, it doesn't make sense to vote for you. But if somebody gets their jollies even doing something that is taboo, if you're good on policy, I will still vote for you.
That's his opinion. So let's go to present day.
That would be ridiculous. We're going to force you to do all these things? That's crazy.
Holy.
And everybody acknowledges that as crazy.
Pick me up.
Why is it not equally crazy to force people to do the opposite? I'm going to force you to not celebrate it because I deserve it. I don't give a fuck what you agree with or disagree with. You can take your fundamentalist religion and go sit in the corner and weep about your miserable life, and you abide by the rules you set up. Other people don't have to do that. Not everybody in Pakistan, not everybody in Indonesia, not everybody in Saudi Arabia agrees with you. It's a matter of freedom and human rights and basic decency. But they don't care because the religion overrides it all. Which goes back to the main point. Only a fundamentalist can say this is a good idea. This is basically a litmus test. Are you a crazy, brainwashed, religious lunatic, or are you a regular person? That's the test. So it's laid out there, and unfortunately, some fail it. But I feel bad for probably the majority of people in Indonesia, Saudi Arabia, and Pakistan.
Out.
Das ist ein feindlicher Sturmsoldat!
Is reporting on a new crackdown against protesters. They say the FBI is investigating political activists campaigning against the Dakota Access Pipeline, diverting agents charged with preventing terrorist attacks to instead focus their attention on indigenous activists and environmentalists. The Guardian has established that multiple officers within the FBI's Joint Terrorism Task Force attempted to contact at least three people tied to the same protector. Scope of the task force's work remains unknown. Agency officials declined to comment, but the fact that officers have even tried to communicate with activists, free speech experts argue that anti-terrorism agents have no business scrutinizing protesters. So, this is outrageous, and as I read this, I was reminded of the fact that the FBI spied on Martin Luther King Jr., and they even sent him a letter basically saying, look, how dare you? You're a fucking philandering piece of shit. So stop doing what you're doing. And you should kill yourself. You're trying to get everyone to suicide. So, the government is undermining.
The sentry kit is available near your location.
Go downstairs, bro.
Putting up roadblocks to people's constitutional rights, their civil liberties, their human rights, and the First Amendment, free speech, free expression, free protest. And here you have really brilliant people who are standing up against this shitty fucking pipeline. By the way, a pipeline blew up very close to the pipeline that, you know, Standing Rock is fighting. So it's the Standing Rock sewer fight. So they act like, oh, it's totally safe for the rest of the world. Actually, no. And furthermore, they converted it just because it was everything in Bismarck. They converted it because it was a white community that was like, oh, great, we'll just put it through the Native Americans' territory. Oh, come on, man. Come on. So you have these people who are doing this brave thing where they're standing up and fighting back. This is the payback they get. People, FBI agents who are supposed to be focusing on terrorism. By the way, another thing Trump did, he said, oh yeah, all the people who are fighting are tasked with looking into domestic right-wing terror groups like Sovereign Citizens, KKK, neo-Nazis, and stuff like that. All the people who are looking at that, no more, none of that at all. Now all Islamic terrorism.
Present.